What's the story behind that fluffy ball on top of your beanie? What's the real purpose of that tiny pocket in your jeans? Find out in Things You Didn't Know the Purpose Of.
Number 15.
Tiny pocket. You may have made up plenty of your own custom uses for that strange tiny pocket on your jeans, whether it be storing hard candies, protecting secret notes, or just holding your loose change. But you might not know what it was originally designed for. Jeans were originally designed at the middle of the 19th century as a more durable pant for the miners that flocked to California in search of gold. One of the most common and important gadgets at the time was the pocket watch. And this pocket was made to snugly hold these sometimes expensive timekeepers. As for those bizarre-looking, often dimpled rivets that adorn your jeans, well, these were an innovation that allowed jeans to further battle the harsh elements of the American frontier. Each one of those rivets is strategically placed in a part of the jeans where the seams were prone to tearing.
Number 14.
Pen cap. You have definitely noticed the tiny hole on top of a cap and may have used it to try and make a whistle, or pretended it was a tiny spyglass. Most people believe this hole has something to do with preventing a pen from drying out, but this is not the case. The hole in the pen cap actually serves as a safety feature. In the event that a small child swallows one, the hole allows air to pass through and reduces the risk of suffocation.
Number 13.
Measuring tape tools. The modern measuring tape machine is a handy invention that most construction workers and contractors can't live without. But even some of the most skilled workers might not know it has two incredible yet simple features. First, there is a serrated edge on the metal end of the tape. This was put into the design so that if you desired, you could put a minor scratch or indentation into the surface you are measuring in order to give you a marker to make further measurements or designs off of. The other feature is right next to the serrated edge. You may have noticed the small hole that is commonly located in the metal tip. So what's the purpose of this? Well, this is so that if you're measuring something from a point where a nail or screw is, you can hook the tape onto the nail and hold the tape in place.
Number 12.
The quarter's edge. You probably have spied the hundreds of tiny grooves that mark the outside edge of a quarter, but not thought twice about it actually having a purpose. But these tiny ridges once served an important function. And no, it's not just so a magician can get a better grip during coin tricks. Up until recently, historically speaking, the cost of the metals in a coin reflected the coin's value, so many people took to shaving the edges off of coins and then used the rest of the coin to purchase items as if the coin still had their full value. They would then save up their shavings and melt them together to create new coins, or just sell the chunks. In order to combat this, coin minters started putting these ridges on their coins so that retailers could tell whether the coins had been shaved. This practice, though not necessary today, is carried on for the sake of tradition and aesthetic. So why don't nickels have them? Because no one cares about nickels.
Number 11.
Handy hole. The modern soda can is an engineering marvel, but you've probably never noticed one of its coolest features, the hole in the tab. You may have thought it only served the purpose of adding grip, but there is a hidden feature that you will kick yourself once you see it. The hole is actually designed so that if you turn the tab around, you can place a straw in it, and it will hold it into place while you sip your sweet treat.
Number 10.
Extra fabric. Chances are you have bought some new clothes at some point and noticed that they came with a little plastic Ziploc bag that had a couple of extra buttons and a swatch of the clothing item's material. We know that the buttons are extras in case you pop one during Thanksgiving dinner. But what's the purpose of the piece of fabric? It is a common misconception that this swatch is extra material in case you get a hole in your clothes and need to patch it up. In actuality, this little piece of cloth is so you can test your detergent or various clothes washing methods on it before risking ruining the nice cardigan you just paid top dollar for.
Number 9.
Cart loops. If you do your own grocery shopping, the odds are you have dealt with a nightmare grocery bagger who, no matter how delicately you originally put your groceries into your cart, just bags them up and throws them in without a care for the crushing of bread and eggs that will ensue. Not saying that you should be a busybody and tell the bagger how to do their job, but maybe next time you can demonstrate how to use this grocery cart feature that even most grocery stores seem to have forgotten. You may have noticed that on the back of the child's seat in the shopping cart, there are small metal loops that jut out. These aren't designed as some weak torture device for children. No, they have an ingenious purpose. You see, these hooks are there so that when you are replacing your now bagged groceries back into your cart, either you or the bagger can hang the bags with the lighter items on them, while the heavier items are put at the bottom of the cart. Such a simple design that has sadly fallen by the wayside.
Number 8.
Half belt. Especially if you live in a colder climate, You may own or have owned a trench coat or jacket that features a small strap on its back, that has a button that attaches to nothing, and that seemingly serves no purpose but looks. Though they may have evolved into a fashion feature, the half belt, as it is known, once was an innovative way to help keep troops warm during winter. Trench coats used to be purposely made oversized so that they could also be used as portable blankets. The half belt on the back was used to keep this extra material buttoned up neat and tidy, so troops wouldn't trip on it while it was being used as a jacket.
Number 7.
Gas gauge arrow. You are guaranteed to be embarrassed over ever parking on the wrong side of a gas pump once you know this next one. You see, automobile manufacturers had already came up with the idea to prevent this from happening ages ago. Next time you look at your fuel gauge on your dashboard, see if you can spot a little arrow next to the pump icon. Whichever way this arrow points is the side that the cap for your gas tank is on. Pretty clever, right? Because it is so rarely noticed, some car manufacturers have stopped putting it on the gauge at all, and some companies have made it so that the side the nozzle is on the gas icon is the side your cap is on.
Number 6.
Converse lacing. Ever since the popular Converse All-Star shoes were first created, people have wondered what purpose the two holes near the sole serve. Most chalk it up to ventilation, but if you really think about it, is adding two holes to produce a little bit of sweat worth getting soggy socks every time you step in a puddle? No, but that's because that's not why the holes are there. As you may well know, Converse were originally designed as basketball shoes, and the holes tie into this design, literally. These holes look exactly like the ones on top that are meant for laces, and this is because they too are meant for laces. The shoe was designed to be laced in several different ways, and if you wanted a tighter grip, or one that ensured you wouldn't trip on your laces while driving the lane, you could use these two extra holes.
Number 5.
Pill bottle top. This one seems like a no-brainer, but there are many people out there who will be shocked to know the dual purpose of the modern-day pill bottle top. You may have glanced at one of these tops once and wondered why there seem to be screw grooves on the part that doesn't go into the bottle. Well, this is because it does. Yes, if you flip the top over, you can use it as an easy-access top. This is for those who don't have children, the elderly, or those who just have trouble opening the normal child-proof cap and need to be able to access their medication in an easier way.
Number 4.
Notebook margins. If you have ever written in a composition book or other type of notebook, you have probably been trained to not write outside the margin. But what is the point of the margin? Is it just to guide your writing? Is it an area for you or your teacher to make notes? Well, this may be the way it is used now, but in reality, the margin was originally created in order to help preserve one's writings. Back in the days when architecture wasn't as pest preventative as it is now, many homes and buildings were infested with rats and mice. These rodents loved to chew on anything and everything, and if you lived back then, your precious book of poetry would have been no different. In order to prevent rats from chewing up valuable parts of a manuscript, notebook and journal manufacturers started adding a margin that could be nibbled at without the fear of losing words to a mouse's gullet. It was also helpful in limiting damage from normal wear and tear, so the practice became standard.
Number 3.
Ketchup cup. If you have ever used one of those paper cups meant for ketchup from a fast food joint, you may have thought, why are these things so flimsy? And why are they so small? Do they really expect this to be all the ketchup I need? But these cups were designed with a brilliant intention that not many people know about. You may have noticed the folds in the side of the cup and wondered why they were there. Well, this is because if you unfold these flaps, the cup turns into a much wider paper saucer, which can be filled with even more ketchup and is much easier to dip your French fries into. This isn't the only common food container that has a semi-secret double use. You probably noticed how Chinese food containers are made up of several flaps folded together. Well, this is because these containers, just like the ketchup cup, are meant to be unfolded. When all the flaps are unfolded and unconnected, the container turns into a handy plate for picnicking. No wonder Chinese restaurants always look at us funny when we ask for paper plates.
Number 2.
Beanie pom-pom. Many people think the pom-pom on top of knitted caps is a cute little accessory, while others may think it frivolous and ugly. But this little fluffy ball actually has a complex history. Knitted caps were believed to be first created by the Vikings to keep their burly ears warm during the icy Scandinavian winter. These hats were made by taking triangles of knitted wool and fastening them at the top. In order to cover up the seams at the top and prevent loose ends, the top was covered up by a pom-pom. Some later versions may have replaced the pom-pom with a button, which, resembling a bean, may have given rise to the term beanie. Later on in history, English sailors would find the pom-pom quite useful in preventing them from hitting their heads when below decks, as the pom-pom feels like an extension of the person's head, so they subconsciously duck a little lower than they normally would. Pom-poms at their most regal period in history would be used by Napoleon's army on top of their helmets. different colors and variating pom-pom plumages were used to signify different regiments, factions, and ranks of the French military.
Number 1.
Panty gusset. If you are a man, you might only know of this one from doing laundry, whereas women might know of this small pocket in their underwear, but might not know its purpose or even what it's called. This little pocket in front of ladies' underwear is called a gusset, and it is added for the purposes of hygiene. The pocket version of the gusset is usually only found in less expensive women's underwear, and is a result of companies saving money by saving the time it would take to stitch up the open part. In many more expensive underwear brands, the gusset is stitched entirely around. Many women have found the pocket version quite useful though, not just for added protection, as it was designed, but for holding hygiene products into place. What is something that you use in a clever way that is different than what it was intended for?